part of Heineken's birthday?
Our national beer dynasty.
Oh, I know. The Heineken Brewers family goes back at least 150 years.
So I wondered, are there any other old European families still present today in my local supermarket?
As a brand, you mean?
Right.
In the way the Heineken family name is still a brand.
Like Freddy Heineken's granddad invented the beer in 1864.
And his grandson made it into today's worldwide success.
It's a nice, different way of looking at our European history.
Instead of the trite stories.
Right, with guns and bombs.
Whoa, a lot of beer competition here.
No panic. Heineken owns many brands in this rack.
And you filmed this one yourself?
Yes, my cameraman had his weekly daddy's day.
Oof, what are you doing? Where are you going?
I know there was another one here.
Ah, Guinness. Brexit beer.
Brexit? No, this is Irish. From Dublin.
Sorry.
It's a stout beer, 8%.
I know.
1759.
Stout is very strong.
Now, that is even older than the United States.
Here, this is Wikipedia. Arthur Guinness was a revolutionary in personnel policy, in wage level,
oh, yes,
paid days off, widow's pension, free education, and free health care.
Europe owes a lot to this man. Now, talking about Brexit.
What is it?
Iced tea.
Lipton iced tea.
Thomas Lipton, since 1870.
Now, I'm sure his tea will get more expensive in Europe.
Because of Brexit? I don't know. If consumers can afford it, who cares?
Brexit is not your glass of tea, is it?
Oh, it is. Absolutely.
But too early to predict what the impact will be on iced tea?
On a single product, it is, yes.
And this is?
Kneipp.
Kneipp.
Now this is a bit different, because only Sebastian Kneipp's name and reputation are linked to the later factory of 1891.
Whoa, listen to this. A Bavarian priest, founder of a new approach to medicine.
I know.
Based on the following five pillars.
Hydrotherapy.
Yes. Herbal medicine, training, grains, vegetables, and a limited use of meat.
Mr. Kneipp formulated what we accept today as being true and important.
And finally, a healthy mind leads to a healthy person.
More than 150 European years ago. Amazing, isn't it? Next.
The Kit Kat family.
1866, Henri Nestlé, Vevey, Switzerland.
Hold on. Wikipedia.
Nestlé developed milk-based baby food and worked with Daniel Peter.
Who invented milk chocolate that did not mold.
Ending up 150 years later as the largest food company in the world.
And Nestlé was German.
I like Nescafe.
And this is?
Another German giant, Friedrich Bayer.
And again with all kind of fantasy Kit Kat names.
But these are pharmaceutical
Wiki.
Again, Bayer is the company.
Since 1863.
But again, all reputations are linked to the names of the products. Like with Nestlé and Kit Kat.
And back to the booze.
Now listen to this. Alessandro Martini founded one of the largest fervent companies in the world in 1863.
Italian? But vermouth, it was invented in France, 18th century.
Right, and inspired on a much older German wine, flavored with a plant in German called vermouth.
Ah, vermouth, very European.
And here's another oldie from Ireland. Scotch whisky, again, 150 years old.
I know this one. William Lawson's did not invent the whiskey.
No, he didn't.
He worked as an export manager for this Irish bottling company.
He did?
And his name got somewhere registered and famous as a product brand.
It's such a great shadowy story. This could be a successful thriller series on Netflix.
From Misty Ireland.
Now this is again a typical European family company.
Phillips.
Started by Gerard, then there was Anton, and later there was Fritz.
Gerard started in 1891.
And the rest is worldwide history. You can still visit the old factory where Philips produced its first incandescent light bulbs.
More Germans here.
Dust bags for vacuum cleaners.
But sold under the name of your local supermarket, AH.
Albert Heijn, I cannot think of any other traditional Dutch family company that is still so much part of the everyday lives of so many Dutch households.
And listen to Wiki. He and his wife started their success story with selling their own daily fresh coffee and cookies.
1887, 130 long European years ago.
Are they builders of Europe?
All 10 of them are great builders of Europe.